Your concerts and your big theater and arena shows, they may never come back, especially not in the same way. They may be outdoors, they may be in the parking lot of stadiums and things like that, but spoken word can come back to the cafes. The Zoom shows and everything that are going on, I dig the hustle, and I appreciate that that's what's keeping the whole feel alive, the movement alive. But even though we have the technology to have virtual shows, it's the same as the technology to have virtual retail. Back in school, one of the teachers talked about the internet, and this is back before the whole .com thing. Amazon.com was around before that whole .com bubble burst, and they're just kind of a survivor in the way that eBay is, but in a way, way better than eBay is. Even though that technology has been around for a while, it doesn't take the place of physical brick and mortar stores. People still want to get out there. When the stores in Los Angeles opened up, I saw people standing outside. They couldn't wait to be in the store, to physically touch the merchandise. It's just the human experience, and it's the same thing with venues. People want to get out there. People want to see each other. People are like neurons, and in close quarters, we recharge better. The connections connect more accurately. So many things that are irreplaceable. If it doesn't become legal before long, I think people are gonna start doing underground poetry events anyway, in their houses and basements. We won't be able to sit as close together, but to be together, that's gonna be worth a lot. It's gotta happen. And I really miss things people learned in their life that they wanna give you so you don't do the same thing. People rhyming, people doing prose, people rocking from paper and still blowing the whole place to bits. Watching that young poet come up for the first time and being the dopest thing that happened all night. I miss how in the New Yorican, if you were a really rhymy poet and they could guess the next thing you're gonna say, like, it's all about the way that I see and I can't wait to get back to nature and find myself sitting beside, everybody would be like, a tree! And then if you do that enough times, you would feel ridiculous. It kind of encouraged people who rhymed to make sure that their rhymes patterns were complicated and that their rhymes themselves weren't so predictable. The whole conversations of grammar at Bogey's, it was a cat named Tariq, had a piece called Doohee. Now, Doohee is grammatically messed up, but the poem only worked because he said Doohee, that he could come there and just be on that whole like Mandingo vibe, talking about Doohee. And he's like, you know, does your man do this? Does your man do that? But if you're saying, does your man do this? It don't rock. Like, do he draw you a bath? Do he massage your neck? Do he? Human nature demands that we come back together, so it's only a matter of time. And what I'm saying is, man, I can't wait.